Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making beer rolls. This is the bread that I've chosen to put on our Christmas table. It's really good and it's so quick and easy to make. I'm going to put into a large bowl 3 cups of Bisquick. Now that's a baking mix that we can get easily here in the United States. For those of you that maybe are not able to get Bisquick, I do have a multi-purpose baking mix in Betty's Kitchen, which is the same thing. So you can use 3 cups of that if you would like to follow this recipe. But this is Bisquick, and I'm adding my 2 cups here and 1 additional cup here. Now we have 3 tablespoons of sugar. And then our third ingredient is beer. This is a 12-ounce bottle of beer. I poured off 2 ounces, so we're using 10 ounces, and it should be at room temperature, so I've had it sitting out. And we'll pour that over the top. And then just mix this together. Once you have your mixture together, then use an ice cream scoop, just a standard size ice cream scoop, and get it full. And then place 1 scoopful in each of these 12 wells of a muffin tin. And this muffin tin has been sprayed with cooking oil spray. This is just the right amount. If you don't have one of these, then you can take a measuring cup, and it's probably going to be maybe a quarter of a cup. But the purpose of using the scoop is to get them all the same size. So we'll go ahead and we'll scoop until we have 12 of them. I think this makes 12. I'm just putting the last one in, and we have 12 of them. This is going to a 450-degree oven. It doesn't take long on these, maybe 10 minutes or so, so you need to watch them carefully. And as soon as they get golden and brown and they're going to rise up, you want to get them out of the oven. You don't want to overbake them at all. Here are our baked beer rolls, and I want to tell you that I left them in the oven at 450 degrees for 7 minutes. And I could see that they were brown along the bottom, but not so much on the top. So I changed it to broil for the last minute that I left them in there. So I only had them in the oven 8 minutes total, the last minute being under broil. Now, if you try to remove these right now, they probably won't release easily. That one I was able to work at and get, but I would let them rest about 2 to 5 minutes and then get them out and put them on a serving plate. Our rolls are piping hot, so I want to take a taste of one before they cool off. I have one over here on my plate, and I have my Christmas tea, just Lipton tea, but it's in a Christmassy mug, so I'm feeling kind of like it's a holiday. I want to show you the texture of these beer rolls. So just going down the center, this is what they look like. Doesn't that look nice? It looks tasty to me. So I'm going to take my knife and get some of the butter, and we'll give it a go. Mmm. I noticed the sugar first because it was a little sweeter than I expected. I expected a little more roll flavor. The beer, I think, plays its part in the rising of these. As far as the taste, it adds a little tang, but you would not say that you're tasting the taste of beer at all, from my perspective. But it's really a nice accompaniment at a nice dinner because it's so easy, so quick to make. And it's going to come out right every time. And you really can't do much to mess it up unless you burn them or something catastrophic. These are really good. They taste wonderful. Take my word for it.